Hi everybody, I'm Coach Christian and today I'm presenting you second video on a series of video on rules. The first video was about target archery, quite an extensive long video that many rules, and archery would take lot more than just the 50 minutes I put on that video, but I think it was enough, or at least it just show the major points on target archery. And today I'm going to show you some rules on field archery. Especially it will be IFAA field archery. I will show you some few differences on to the world archery, field archery. On the next video, the third video, will be a lot more extensive, showing the difference, the real difference between world archery and IFAA. But this video will be just about field archery. On the video about target archery, I told you target archery, it's precision shooting. And that's true. You stand on a fixed spot, you just feel your foot there, you have enough time to get used to that spot shooting, you have a fixed position of your target, and you will be shooting, if you do the Olympic round, 72 arrows on the same target, at the same distance, the same place, nothing will change, unless there's not an earthquake, there will be nothing change, it will be exactly that same thing. And if you travel from Brazil to China or to Japan or wherever you want to travel, you always will have the same conditions. Weather conditions may change, some position may change, but the shooting conditions, the target, the distance, where you stand, how you stand, will be always the same. Field archery, I call it challenging archery. I mean, if you do target archery, challenge is still to try to hit all your arrows at 10 at 70 meters, or if you're a compound shooter, everything at 50 meters. That's a challenge. But when I'm talking about challenge on field archery, from the point of view of field archery, is that you will give, if you do a world archery, rules, 3 shots. If you go for IFAA, you will do 4 shots on a hunter or a field round. If you do an animal round, you may do just 1 shot, 1 up to 3 shots. We'll be talking about that just in a minute. And every time you finish that round, be it 3, be it 4, be it 1 shot, doesn't matter. You go on to the next target. And the next target will be a different distance, different conditions of shooting, different terrain. You may shoot down, you may shoot up, you may shoot across a valley, you may shoot across a lake. Target may be bigger, maybe smaller. If you are IFAA, you will be walk on targets. That's incredible, special for people like me who shoot instinctive archery, bow hunter division. It's quite a challenge at 80 yards. Sometimes the target is in between the target. If it's like an 80 yard target, an example, and where you're shooting, there's a small hill in between it. This, for people who are shooting with other sight, it's a huge challenge, because that small hill gives you a wrong feeling for your subconsciousness about distance. That's fantastic, you know? That's a real challenge. Depending on the field you are, depending on the kind of competition the organizer is putting up, he can make an extreme field archery competition where you will be shooting out of the most impossible positions, you know? On top of a tree, on top of a rock, all the way down, let's say nearly 100 degrees down. I mean, it's all straight to the floor, down. That's what I call challenge. You'll be shooting, you'll be testing your technique, you'll be testing your way of shooting under the most diverse terrain conditions. Sometimes you must squat, you must open your legs more, sometimes you must put one leg on the floor, one knee on the floor, I mean, just to get a better shooting position. Sometimes you just put your two foot 1 year as totally together, and this will show how good your technique is, how good your aiming capability is, how good you are capable in adapting your technique, your way of shooting to the most different conditions. That's field archery. So about the differences between IFAA and World Archery, as I told, I will be talking on another moment, on another video, the third video. Today, just let's look and enjoy a little about field, at the targets that exist, at the type of competitions they're existing, and have some fun. I see you just in a second. Okay, there we go. Let's start looking at some of the targets you will find on a field archery competition. On the back here, as you can see, is a Olympic style at 70 meters recurve target. This black, full black with a white center, is a target that you will use at IFAA hunt around for the longest distance, which is 70 yards, which are around 63 meters. This here, you have this black, white, and black target. That's a field round by IFAA. Then you have this animal round here, where we're just talking in a second about it. And here you have a target for one of the middle range distances for World Archery Field. So World Archery Field has just one target, one type of competition, which has a yellow center and everything black, and it goes from 6 to 1. So 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If we shoot at IFAA, be it hunter round or field round, the center, the entire center, counts 5 points. The middle ring counts 4 points. The outer ring counts 3 points. And here it's the same. Black, it's 5 points. White, 4 points. The other black one, it's again 3 points. On an animal round, you will be shooting one arrow. If your arrow hits the animal, depending where it hits, gets a score. So this bigger is a smaller area here. It's called kill zone. If you hit here, you get maximum score, which is 20 points. If you hit the other part, which is delined by this line here, it's called a wound zone. So you will just get 2 points less, 18. If you miss the animal, you hit his tail, which is not inside his body line, or the tip of his ear, which is not inside this body line. If you just miss this animal, you go on and you will be shooting a second arrow. And you will be walking on the longer distances. And on the short distances, you just be shooting exactly the same spot. Your second arrow, if you hit the center here, he gets 2 points less than the wound zone of the first arrow. So, first arrow, you get 20, 18. Second arrow, you get 16. And if you hit here, 14. If you miss again, you can shoot a third and last arrow. If the third arrow hits here, you get 2 points less than the previous one. So you get a 12. And if you hit the wound zone, you get a 10 point. If you miss, you just get a miss. On those targets, you will be shooting all 4 arrows at the target, and you get the sum of those 4 arrows. If you shoot World Archery Field, you will be shooting 3 arrows, not 4. Here you shoot 4 by FAA. Here you just shoot 3 arrows, and the sum of those 3 arrows. On the FAA, there's still one more kind of competition I don't have. It's a 3D. If you have, it's like an animal made out of ethafoam. And there are different types of competitions and rules on it. There's a rule where you shoot only one arrow. If you hit, you hit. If you miss, you miss. Then the rule where you can shoot up to two arrows, and a rule that you will be following this year where you shoot three arrows at the target. World Championship in IFAA, you will be using those three targets. You will be shooting the first day a field round, then you will be shooting a hand round, then you will be shooting the third day an aimer round, and the fourth day you will shoot a field round, and the last day a hunter round. Okay, then with the animal, with those three D's, there is an extra competition. It's called bow hunter competition. This year will be in South Africa, 2013, which is separated. There are unmarked distances. Those here, those three competitions here, usually they're all marked distances. At the World Championships, they're marked distances. Being that the organizer, he can decide to put this animal round as unmarked distance. On World Archery, you will be shooting one day on this kind of targets here with marked distances, and the second day with unmarked distances. And this will give you a classification. After that classification, you have the elimination rounds. Here, the winner is by the sum of the total of the scores during the 5 days. Okay, so let's just watch a couple other targets. World Archery as well as IFAA, you have four target sizes. Here we have a field round of IFAA. That's the biggest, it's 65 centimeter diameter target for the longest distance, which goes from 50 to 80 yards. You'll be shooting on such big targets. The distance, they interlap on the target sizes, okay? For all distances, when you shoot IFAA, it's irrelevant what kind of a bow you shoot. If you are, you will be always shooting inclusive the longest distances. If you shoot World Archery and you shoot recurve and compound with the sight, your longest distance will be 70 meters. The target is the one I just showed you before. For the long distance, it's 80 centimeter diameter. It's a little bigger than this one. If you are a bow hunter, that means you're shooting without a sight, you're shooting just with one fixed anchor point. Bow hunter in IFAA, you'll be shooting the same distance. In World Arch, if you're a bare bow, that means you can do string walking. Then your longest distance will be 50 meters with the same target as the people with a sight shoot at 70 meters. That's an indoor. You have IFAA and World Archery have indoor competitions. We will be talking about that on another video. And this here is for the archers with a sight, and this for all other archers and beginners and those who are not so good. And it seems that this white spot here is a lot bigger than that one, but that's an illusion. It's an optical illusion. So here you have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So you go from 5, all white, up to 1. You're just 5 and 4. If you miss, it's just miss. Here's a nice comparison between indoor World Archery and indoor IFAA. And again, the center, it's exactly the same size. Okay? What is different are the size of those rings. And in World Archer, you go from 10 to 6. Here you go 5, 4, or 5 to 1. That's the difference. Okay, so let's watch a couple of fields and look at them during competition, how you put up a field and some really nice places. This year, I like very much this pics of this competition It was in Pedreira, in São Paulo, here in Brazil. As you can see, quite up and downhill. So if you do field archery, it's not just shooting. And especially if you do IFAA field archery, it's a lot also about walking. And accordingly, depending on the area you have, the landscape, and who's organizing it, you can have it an easygoing field archery competition, like it was during the World Championship in Argentina. It was fairly flat, plain, some hills going up and down, but it was not much of a walk. It was not much of an just pushing you physically to your limits by walking. This Pedreira, it really pushes you to your limits. It's a really nice place to shoot at. So we had a couple of shots where we shoot from down here where the truck is, all way up and other way around. And then you must walk up and walk down to get your arrows. That's very nice. And as you can see, that's us putting up the field, the butts here. We need to take a truck. It's a big farm here. So that's one of the lakes. On one part, we just shot halfway across the lake, and then we had a butt just on the corner to the lake, and we were shooting at the butt and the lake behind the butt. So everybody was a little afraid. If you miss a butt, you will lose your arrow. It will just fall into the lake. So here, putting up. As you can see, the targets here, it's a field round, IFAA field round. Those are pegs for the kids. For in IFAA, you have three categories. You have the infants, and you have juveniles, and you have adults. That's one of the pegs. So that means this target, it's a walk-on target. In IFAA, you have three different type of shooting position or shooting forms. One, you shoot all your four arrows from the same spot. Then you have a walk-on. That means by short distances, you will shoot two arrows from one spot, and you give a couple of steps, and you shoot the next two arrows at the same target. Or you just shoot four arrows and each arrow from a different position, walking on in direction to the target. That's for people, in my case, who shoot bow hunter instinctive, quite a challenge. Because on the first arrow, if you hoped you just got the reference for the next three arrows, gone. You must walk on to the next spot to shoot again. And then you will need another reference. And then you have what we call like a fan. Those are like four pegs, one on the side of the other, and then you shoot at the target from those four different directions. It's really interesting. Sometimes you have like a fan, just two pegs, so you shoot two arrows on one target, and then you move on and to shoot arrows on the next target. So it's just showing us working to put up the target. So as you can see, there were a couple of shots we needed to walk all the way up here, you know. And then you will see on another position we have a shot where we shot from top here all the way down. And that's what makes us also challenging on the field, especially if it's IFAA. And we'll be talking about in the next video about the differences. Whoops, sorry. Let's just get the camera really nicely put on that picture. We will be showing on the next video the difference between World Archery and IFAA. Here I just want to give you the taste what it is to shoot field archery. And the nice on the field archery is wherever you go in the world, the field will be always different. You never will be shooting at exactly the same field at exactly the same distances, because countrysides are all different, and some are hills. More hill, others are completely flat, like here in Brasilia, everything is very flat. So I don't have this challenge of height differences. for training, unfortunately. It's really a pity. Others have a lot of forest and you shoot a lot inside the forest. So each place is different, and that's a challenge, because you not only go to a field competition for shooting and shooting at a target, you're also going to get to know that place, to see, wow, how do the organizer have put up that field, from where they expect us to shoot, what will be the challenges, the difficulties, and so on. And it's always something new. It's always a new discover of the landscape and of your abilities in shooting. It's really fun field. I really can recommend all archers, target archers, to shoot field. I think it's a great thing to improve their skills and their capabilities of shooting. Here, as you can see, there's some person standing here. So on this one, we shot all across this small lake. It was a 50-yard target, as you can see. Target up here. We put it up here. Then here we walked just. We had a target from the top here to shoot down. Then we needed to walk up. Had an up target going on here. As you can see here, it's a short distance target. You'll see. So you will be shooting. Let's go back. You will be shooting two arrows here, and then you move on to the side and shoot another two arrows on another target. This can also be a walk on target, and you will be going shooting from down. I think it was at something around 20-yard target. Here it's a nice valley. As you can see, we use this valley, this area, to put a couple of targets. And you need to walk all the way up here to shoot to the next target. Here on the bottom, we had one target here. And now we just put it here inside. That was, I think, a kind 12 yards or something way down shot on a walk-on. You were shooting two arrows on one side, and you would step forward and shoot another two arrows. Then we put it up here in a target, shooting from here, I think it was a 65-yard target, shooting all across this valley on a target was just below this shadow here. So we will just check that. I just show you a little around the surroundings and the ways to go up and down, so you can get an idea that field archery is not just shooting, it's also a lot of challenge, physical challenge for your body. As you see, this year it's a four-pack walk-on. So you see those four targets. So on the first, you shoot up here. Then on the second, you just walk, I think it's a yard. Then you shoot on the second. And then you walk more yard. It's like a Z you must shoot here. Then you shoot here. And then you walk on and you shoot here. And so each one determines where he's shooting. On this field place, we had only 14 butts. So we did a 14 butt round, and then we went to have a small break, and then we did it against the 14 butts. So at the total, we added 28 butts, which is the official competition. So if you're on the first 14, you shot, let's say on this target, left up, you will need on the second round or after 15 targets, you swap. So you will be then on the 16th, shoot right down, just inverted. And who was here will shoot up here, and so on. Just to give an opportunity for everyone to shoot once on the top or once on the bottom, and to be more fair. Here, as I told you, just on the shade, we put in a nice target with a 65-yard shot. Really fun. So the one with the four targets, we were shooting from here. You see the peg here, the number, yellow. We are shooting all the way down here, and here was the target. This other one we are shooting from here. So you can see target number, I think number 7. We're shooting all the way down here. So this here was a 80-yard target, and the target was put
below this shade here, on this back here. And when you were shooting from here, there would be a hill in between you and the target. You would see the target, but the hill would just give you a different feeling of distance. For instinctive shooter, quite a challenge. That's here us carrying the targets up the hill. So one day before we put up that archery field, so we do a lot of physical exercise already by putting up the field. And the truck, he did not manage to go all the way up, so he stopped here. And so we needed to walk all the way up the hills to put up those targets. Quite an exercise. Here, that's the 80-yard distance target. Impressive. And here we have, you see, number 10 here. Find ranger, you always use in FITA, also in World Archery and FAA, just to get sure of your distance, a find ranger. If you're shooting FAA and it's marked distances, you are allowed to use a find ranger to determine the distance from your target, because find rangers are not all 100% equal. They have a difference, and depends also a lot of how you use those find rangers. So if someone has, let's say, a compound bow, and he has his find ranger, and he has tuned his bow, he has the sight for his bow for his find ranger, so it's better he has his own find ranger, so he gets the right distances and the right marks on his sight. For us instinctive shooters, even gap shooters, if it's a yard near or a yard farther away, makes not so much of a difference. So that's the target, is 80 yards. This one is an up-go target. And it's kind of a tricky target, because you, I think it's a 32 or 35 yard target. And just on the back is woods, you know. If you miss this target, you would just lose your arrow in the wood. But a couple of people are just scared. And here, as you can see, it, when you shoot from the bottom, it makes like a bump. You know, giving you, and behind this bump, you still have a 1 to 1.5 yard distance to the target. So for instinctive shooters, it's quite a challenge, because sometimes you end up getting a wrong estimate of distance. Here we're walking all up here because we put up a target on the top. And here we have a nice view of the walking and how an IFAA field, archery field, can be. Here, another nice picture. Look here at the landscape. And in the FAA field archery, you try to use this entire landscape in your favor to make it as much diverse as possible, the competition. Again, just to show you, one target here, the next target up here. Landscape, beautiful. And here we see it, okay? That's an 80-yard distance shot. That's quite a distance. And then we had from here, I think it was from here all the way up here, another target. So if you do IFAA, you shoot from here, then you walk to this target, you walk all the way down, that's a cow here, you see here? It's like a farm with a lot of cows. It's not a 3D. It's a real live cow and not supposed to shoot at. And you walk all the way to this target. And once you get your arrows and get your score, you just go on and walk to the next. That's one of the differences, which I will be talking in the next video, between World Archery and IFAA. World Archery will be walking back to the shooting position, then walking on to the next target. IFAA, no. You come here, you walk to the target, and from this target, you walk on to the next shooting position, you shoot at the target, from here you walk on to the next shooting position. Also one, you see here, you walk to the next shooting position, then you walk all the way up this hill, and from here, from the top, you shoot down a 65-yard distance target. A nice picture of the tree here. Here's a lake. We did not shot across, but sometimes they put up a field where they start here, where they shoot from one side to the other on this lake here. That's huge. I mean, lakes give you a complete different sensation of distance, you know, and it's a tremendous challenge. That's everybody putting the bows. You see, we have compound shooters, we have bow hunter, here we curve shooters. You have compound with scope sight here, as you can see. Then you have compound without anything, like bow hunter. Here you have someone with a longbow division. Here it's a longbow. Everybody here is, I think he was shooting a bow hunter division. Ah, a couple of us, myself here, shooting with my Samik wood bow on the bow hunter division, a couple of people shooting longbow, and you can also shoot bow hunter with aluminium cast bow. That's one of the targets. Just you see one pack, that's just one pack. That means we were shooting four arrows from the same spot. Usually, when you do IFAA, all the world archery, you shoot two people at the same time. The difference is that at world archery, you have a determined time to shoot. IFAA, it's kind of open. You have enough time to give your shots. You don't have a time pressure. According to the terrain, and they put that peg in a place, it was not possible for two people to shoot at the same time. So we shot one person, then shot the next one, and shot the next one, and so on. And in IFAA, your foot must be touching this, or being up to 3 foot, 3 foot to the left and the right. And I think it's like a couple of inches, 7 inch away from that peg. So ideal is to have your foot nearby this peg. If you shoot world archery, you have 1 meter circumference position to position yourself around the shooting peg. Okay, so usually you have your foot somewhere nearby this year with a surround a little around 1 meter or 3 foot a yard distance around this peg to shoot at. That's the people walking to the targets. Here's one target, here's one shooting position. This was, you see, it seems very nearby, but it was actually a 45 yard distance target, you know. You see, here it's nice. You see adult, 30 yards, juvenile, it's equal to adults, and infant, 10 yards. So, and you shoot 3 times in the same position at that target. Here we have bow hunter compound. That means a compound bow without a sight, without clicker, anything, just a small 12 inch stabilizer. That's the kids. Adult shoot from here. You shoot 4 arrows from the same position on this side. Two archers shoot here, the next 2 archers shoot on the other target, and you must shoot, hit your target. That's a bow hunter. That's Klein. Is the one who organizes competition. He shoots too. That's something very nice. When you do EFA field archery competition, and you can put it up, the field, you can organize that field, and you can shoot, because you don't have judges walking around on the field. So you don't need to be a judge on that field. The group is a judge for themselves. So IFAA, when you have a group of archers, you have one who is a chief of group. He will count the arrows. He will say the score of the arrows. Usually, by the rules, is the first one in the list. But when a group comes together and the first one doesn't want to be the captain of the team, he just can delegate that to someone else. At the World Championship in Argentina, we had in our group one who was a lot, he was an old dude in IFAA, and most of us were just newbies in the FAA, so we were happy to delegate to that person the position as a captain of the team, even so he was third on the in the order of the list of the names of our group. So, but if there is a quarrel, if everyone wants to be captain, very simple, the first one on the list will, of that group will be captain, the next two will be scorers, and the last one or the last two, sometimes you can have up to five archers shooting in one group, will pull the arrows. So the other thing which you have, which is also a little different, I told you in the last video about World Archer rule, which says a shot arrow is a shot arrow and you're not allowed to replace arrows. So if you get a bounce off or get a through arrow, you must go there and find where the hole is, and that will be your score. Even on field you have that, so this requires a judge walking around on that field place. If in IFAA you don't have that, IFAA, if an arrow bounces, you shoot again. If an arrow gets through, you shoot again. Only counts arrows you can see, that you can know they hit there. It makes it a lot easier. You don't need to have so many judges around, and it's just faster. Competition just goes on faster. So that disadvantage is, if you hit a center, it's a 5, an X, and it bounces off. Ooh. I mean, if you have a sight, maybe it's not so difficult, but if you are an instinctive shooter, you're very happy when you hit the X, and then you need to shoot again. That's pretty tough. But from the other point of view, things go a lot faster, is a lot less headache, it's a lot more light, everybody laughs more, don't take so much serious, so much, not serious, you take it serious, but not too stern, you know? So, and it's no quarreling about where is that hole and if this is a hole or not the hole and whatever and so on. So that's one of the small difference between World Archery and IFAA. Here you see they're shooting up here, target 5 up here. It seems that it's on the way, but it's actually not. See, go up here, they shoot up here. As you can see, walking down, that's a nice shot. You see, he's standing here and he's shooting all the way across this valley. It's a 65 yard, or I think 70 yard target. You see target here and he's shooting here. Whoops, let's go back up here, shooting all the way here, all the way down here. And after you shot, you just walk. You cannot walk down here. It's kind of too steep. It doesn't look like so, but it is. So you just walk like in zigzag, like a Z, up and on the sides, or down here, you cross that fence, you get your arrows, and you move on to the next target. This is a short distance target. I think it's a walk up target with two pegs. This here is an up target with four pegs. You see as the kids, they have like a walk on. So adults also have a walk on with four different distances. That means you will shoot one arrow and then you walk on, shoot the next arrow, you walk on, shoot the next arrow and so on. This here, it's a really fun target. It was just put this in this hole and you will be shooting. That's an 80-yard target. On this we will just come in a second. There's an 80-yard target, you see? He's shooting here from the 70-yard. He already shot one arrow, which was 80. Then he shoots here from 70. Then he walks down here, you see? This peg here, I think that's a 60-yard, and then he must walk up here. We cannot see the peg. That's a peg of 50-yard. So you have always a different direction to the target here. As you can see, adult will shoot 80, 70, 60, and 50 yards. That's in meters. And juvenile will shoot just all four arrows of 50 yards. And infants, they will also have a walk on. 30, 25, 20, 15 yards. Infants up to 12 years of age. From 12 years on, you are juvenile until you reach 17 years. From 17 on, you are adult. The nice thing on IFAA competitions, inclusive world competitions and so on, is that you have 11 different types of bows being valid, being taken serious, inclusive at international world competitions. And from this year on, you have a professional division. You already had one for compound, and from this one year on, you have a limited compound professional division and a recurve, limited recurve professional division. That means a recurve with a side and so on. So that's really great. But about those differences, we talk in the next video. Here, so you see, he shot here 70 yards, here he shoots 60 yards, and here he shoots 50 yards at this target here. And here in front, from down here, it's terrible. It's like a bump here. And when you're looking from down here, over here, this bump is like a small hill, stays in front of the target. And when I shot first time at this distance, at 80 yards was okay, but then the other distances, signs this bump, just behind the bump, at around 10 to 15 yards to the target, all my other three arrows were grouping exactly the same spot. That means this bump just messed up with my distance judgment for my instinctive shooting. But it was quite an experience. And here you can see a walk on target, 1, 2, 3, 4 pegs. That means you shoot one arrow here, then you shoot another arrow, then another arrow, and then another arrow. This will have it in EFA in field round as well as an animal round. Here, this is a down target. You remember the one I said we will be talking about? This is like a mold here. It's like a hole. And we're shooting from 65 yards all the way down. It's quite steep here, you know? You see here, and we are here. We shoot from top here, on the butt, all the way down here. And we walk down this slope here. It's fun. It's a lot of fun. And a couple of beautiful pictures of surrounding here. Shooting first peg, second peg, third peg, and fourth peg. Uphill, around, I think it was something 30 yards uphill. That's a nice view of surroundings. And all targets should have something like that, where it says the distance where you shoot from, those four arrows from the same distance, a juvenile, adult, and infant, from which distance each one group shoots. There's a 65 yards, I think that was a 65 yards, target all the other way on the slope here with a valley in between. And here is shooting upwards to this other target. I think it's also a 45, 50 yard target. Yo, do you see the arch and target? Arch is up here. Here, archer, 65 yards, shooting up down here, 65 yards. There we see the picture again. 50 meters, 55 meters, that was around a 60 yard shot across that pond, that small lake, the target. That's a walk-on target. We just saw target and shooter. So you have one second spot, third place, and fourth place to shoot at this target, one arrow each time. 60 yards below that tree. 60 yards, okay, that's 60 yards walking down. And that was the part on hunter round. And now I want to show you a couple of pics on animal round. This is in another place. It's like a farm with a lot of trees surrounding. So we just put up a beautiful archery field up here. Animal round, you will be shooting, I think it's 60 yards, the longest distance. We'll just check that on the next video. hunter round is 70 yards and field round is 80 yards, the longest distance. As you can see, it's a farm, a couple of cows down here. It's a really beautiful place in among of those grown up palm trees. He had like a sanctuary with Nossa Senhora, very Catholic people. Here we have group four. So on animal rounds, you also have four sides of animals for group of targets. That's 10 to 20 yards. That means whoever organized a competition can put at any one of those distances here. It can be a marked distance, it can be unmarked distances. So all of those were marked distances, but you could put this on an unmarked distance, and then whoever was shooting now, this animal can be something between 10 and 20 yards, that means 9 and 80 meters. There it is. We were just shooting through those two trees. They seem to be quite wide, but when you just, I think we were just a couple of five yards away from here. That looks very narrow. I just said the owner of the farm. It's a really beautiful farm put up. And we just putting here, it's another animal. Again, the kill zone, the warm zone here. That's Jorge Bagato, our president of Field Brazil, until 2nd of February this year. From then on, he is getting out as a president, and a new one will be elected. He did a really great job. I have to thank him a lot that he convinced me to go to the World Championship in Argentina, which was a huge, exceptional experience. Here, again, we have a truck to help to carry the butts and put up the field. They are like walking. See, beautiful landscapes, up and down hill. Here we have mungos shooting something around, 20, 30 yards. Here we have group four, 10 to 20 yards. But they put this in a pretty far there. I think we were shooting at 20 yards at that little beast here. Here it's a walk on, as you can see those pegs. Here, see, 1, 2, 3, 4 positions walk on. 12 targets, that was nearby against a small animal. This I think we shot from 10 yards. And for the kids nearby, for the adults here, he also has you see it. I just forgot the name now. That's a nice. This was a duck in between here. And we are shooting down in the slope, downwards. Quite a challenging shot. That's the room where I stay with my bow. Some people were camping at that place, and then were some people selling some. That's the backyard of his place here. That's just a living room, like an open living room, and they had like up to 30 yards space to shoot at, and people just having their warm up and doing some shots. This is a knife being sold. This guy, he makes those knives by himself. Very beautiful knives. His wife, and he's the guy who makes those knives. Here's a place, as you can see, the targets on the back. Everybody's sitting around and having a good time. And here's a landscape, as you can see. You use actually the landscape, the total land, as much as you can use, you use it to put up your field. You have compound, you have recurve, you have longbow, bow hunter. You see this arrow here with German colors. I mean red and yellow. I'm German, living in Brazil, and born in Africa. So that's my arrow. It was a kill zone, first arrow. I was really happy about that. And here you have, I think it was a 65. If you shoot an arrow, you miss, you walk on to shoot the next arrow. If you miss, you walk on to shoot the next arrow. So I think this was 65, and we come nearby. Ha! See? I shot first arrow, I missed. On my second arrow was a kill zone. So it was a walk on target. On my group, we are only compound shooters. I was the only one recurve shooter. Another nice target, a pretty nice distance. This was a big place here, which we used to put up some 5-6 targets. So it was really nice. We put up 14 targets on this area he has. And it was not too big, not too much walking, but still nice, challenging. It was really nice. And there we go. Finished. I hope you enjoyed. Oh, that's a nice pic. So across a small way. You remember the one cat we put it up, I showed you in the beginning? This is like a hawk up in the woods. This is a bear. I think it's 65 yards. It's still here. I think it's 65 yards. As you can see, one shoots and the next shoots and so on. And as you can see, it's a walk on. If you shoot one, you miss, you walk on to the next peg, you shoot on. If you miss, you walk on to the third peg. And here you see some red pegs. Those are for the infants, for the little ones. And you can shoot two people at a time or one at each time. And usually when you put up a field, you leave a space between the first and the second group. So if one group shoots a little faster, he just will not be waiting too long until the second group finish shooting. You just have one or you have a buffer between the groups. If you can allow yourself to do that, you have a buffer between the groups of archers. This was a nice, was like a duck standing high. Yeah, my arrow. A nice shot, a wound zone. That was 18 points. Those two were compound shooters. They shot 20 points each. And another difference between IFAA and World Archery is to count the higher score, be it animal round or hunter round or field round, your arrow must cross that line. So this line belongs to the higher score, belongs to the lower score, sorry. And then you must cross it. The arrow must visibly cross this line, you must cut that line to count the score. Okay, a nice picture. Oh, look, first arrow on here, first shot. Very nice, happy. That's my arrow here. And that's it. Okay, let's see here. So let's just take one of those targets. You see this line here, we see here. This belongs to the, actually this one is 4 points, this 3 points. And here, this delimitation here, it belongs to the lower score. So for you to get a 4 point, you really must cut that line. You must pass through that line with your arrow. On World Archery, if it just touches a line, it counts a higher score. In IFAA, no, it must get through. And who decides that? You don't have a judge. Common consensus. You were at the World Championship, we did it very easy. The captain would call a score, the owner of the arrow will look at it. If he doesn't agree, the other archers will look and then decide. That's a score that everyone thinks it is okay. And it was that score. Point end. Democratically solved. So this makes a lot easier competition and a lot less headache, because everyone must cooperate in determining a score. Okay, I hope you enjoy that. I hope it helped you to get a feeling for field archery, to see it's not so complicated and it's a lot of fun. And people in Europe and United States, England and so on, they are very lucky. There are a lot of field competitions going on. If you are a target archer, do field. You will enjoy it very much. It's really a lot of fun. And especially FAA field competitions are a lot of a challenging in walking and shooting and having possibility to meet a lot of nice people. I hope you enjoy that video and I see you for the next video.